Hey everyone, welcome back to Returning to Basics. I'm Neil. If you remember, we have a place up in the Ozarks. We call it Dogwood Trace. We purchased that a number of years ago, and it was a little simple 20 by 20 one-room cabin. Had no water, just had electricity. We've expanded that, made it into a small home, and it's for us a second home, vacation home, project home on the 40 acres that we have up there that we are developing. We're doing timber stand improvement on it. We're improving the property, planting fruit trees, doing different things. But one of the things that we did at Dogwood Trace was we said to ourselves, hey, we're trying to live a more sustainable lifestyle in our older years since we've retired. Why don't we make that cabin, that we call it, capable of being off-grid? It is not off-grid, it's connected to the grid, but we have designed it so that it can be off-grid. And so we have solar, and we have 12-volt power to our water well, and we have all the capacity so that if we have no grid connection, we can survive up there and get by. We're doing that for self-reliance. We're doing that to save money. We're doing that to be prepared for whatever happens in the future. And so today I'm doing something for Dogwood Trace that I thought you'd be interested in seeing. I'm making an off-grid washing machine. Stay with me. Okay, what you need for an off-grid washing machine is you need a drill. And I've got my simple 18-volt rechargeable. You might need a pocket knife. I have mine here. I've got one of those Unibits. And you're going to need a plunger. And we bought this plunger for a dollar at the Dollar Tree. And I've already put the three holes in it because it was a little bit difficult. But you need holes in the plunger so that it won't suction to the bottom of your container here, your 5-gallon pail. You need it to be able to move up and down and water to move freely. And so you put some holes in there. You don't have to put holes as big as I did, but you do need some holes to break the suction. And this is your agitator. Then you need a water holding bucket, and then you need the inner bucket. It's going to go inside of your first one. And this is the bucket where you'll do all of your cleaning and your agitation. This bucket needs holes in it. And so that's why we have the drill. And you wonder, what do we have the third bucket for? Well, we have the third bucket to carry more water, to carry clean water from our rainwater system, if we're using off-grid water, or to pump it up from the well, which we pump up with 12-volt with an RV style pump. And it takes care of the whole house. And so you have your water there, but you need your bucket here with holes in it so that you can pull it out and drain and work. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put three or four holes in the bottom, probably about two-thirds as big as this Unibit. And man, they cut really well. And if you have to live with a spouse like I do and live in the house with her later, I have the garbage can out and I have the little cordless vac as well. And so I have that so that I'll be able to live with her so I can clean up my mess. Now then, you need some holes in the sides as well. Just like the inside container in your washing machine, in your regular washing machine, you need holes in it just like that. So, and there you go. I'll stop here for a minute and clean up after myself. That's my mail alert. We took a $12 driveway alert and put it in our mailbox, and we brought the beeper inside here. We mounted it on the door so that when the mailman comes and he lowers the door, it beeps and we know that our mail is here. That prevents us from having to walk out there two or three times during the day to see if our mail has run. So that notified us that our mail has run. That's a good thing that you might want to do for your home. If you take your drill and run it around like this, this Unibit will cut out all those little shavings. Okay. Pause for a moment. Clean up. Okay, it's got a few little ones stuck on the side there, but we'll get those off. So there's your inside cleaning pail, the one that you use to agitate your clothes. You put that one inside a regular pail that you've done nothing to, not modified it in any way. This holds your water. This allows you to agitate your water and your clothes and move them up and down. And you put your detergent in here, and you put your clothes in here. And of course, you can't put very much. But one of the things that we found is you need to totally cover your clothes with water. You can't be extremely conservative with water here. You have to actually use a bit. But of course, in off-grid, what we do, and if you don't know what we do, I'm going to put a link right up here to another video on how to save rainwater, because we capture thousands of gallons of rainwater off the roof every year, so we have plenty of water in an off-grid situation, both here and at Dogwood Trace. And so here you go. Here's your little ingenious no-power off-grid washing machine. However, to keep from splattering all over yourself, you can make yourself a top, put a hole right here in the middle, and that's what we're going to do next. So right here in the middle, let's see if that'll go over. Sure will. Okay, put all those down in there, at least for now. And this isn't to seal it. My goodness, and all the little orange and white flecks that it made. Since they're all plastic and this is winter, when we're making this, we have a lot of static electricity. Most of them are down there or they're stuck to me. But what you do is you put the handle for your agitator plunger here. You put it in there. And now you're able to sit here and to do this. And my recommendation is that you do sit down whenever you use these, because it's terrible on your back otherwise. So you need to be able to sit here and do this, and you can just plunge away. And for a few dollars, I'm talking about very few dollars, you have yourself an off-grid washing machine that will work. A lid, a plunger, a couple of these, one internal basket with holes, one outside container to hold the water, and then we have elected to use one other one to carry water back and forth. And whenever you finish washing your clothes, you're going to need to rinse them, and so you can just take them right out, take your agitator out, lift your bucket out, and you can just set it in here slowly and let it go down in there, and you can rinse them in the water. You can pour out this water, clean water here, to rinse again, move them over here, do this, go back and forth until you've rinsed your clothes good. You'll probably need to agitate them a little bit while you're rinsing to get the soap out. And if you don't have a wringer, I suggest you get a wringer. And we bought one from, who did we buy that from? Teresa?
Let me get the box.
She's going to get the box. We bought it from one of these organizations that sells off-grid and Amish-type lifestyle products. And we bought ourselves an old-fashioned wringer, and you can literally wring your clothes through that. And you need, you know, the other thing you need for this process is you need a good clothesline. And you can string one of those up between corners of your house out here, put up one pole, run it from the corner of the house, or you can put it between two trees. We have ours between a couple of trees up there. And it also serves as a dog run, so we can leash the dog on it and the dog can run on it sometimes. And so that works, that dries your clothes. You can also put one up on the inside of your house. We have one up out here in the sunroom that we use regularly in the house. We just run it across there and clip it on the other side. It's retractable and works really, really well. Let's see that thing. Does it say where it came from, Teresa? And that's one of the things that you would need to help you in an off-grid laundry situation, a hand wringer. So thanks, Teresa.
And it's heavy.
It's very heavy, but we've taken it out of the box and looked at it, and they work very good. You probably remember your grandmother having an old, what we called wringer washing machine, and she washed with it and then ran things through the wringer, but be careful, you can get your fingers caught in there too. They have a safety feature to open that up. You haven't lived if you're not our age and you haven't gotten your fingers caught in a wringer washer.
He would have to build a little stand for this heavy wringer to mount on.
Not have to, I will. I'll end up building a station, and we'll do a video on that where I can put the washing machine on it, build a washing station for outside out of wood, and we'll be able to mount the wringer and we'll show you that. So there you go, for a few dollars from Dollar Tree and from the local Home Depot, Lowe's, Walmart, or wherever, you can get a few of these 5-gallon pails and you can make an off-grid washing machine.
Less than 20 bucks.
Less than $20. And to conclude, you can also make your own detergent. Teresa has a recipe for how to do that.
You can find it online. It's easy.
Yeah, you can go online, find what you need to do, how the components you need to get together to make detergent as well. We're not advocating that. You can buy a lot of Tide or whatever, you know, powdered washing machine, washer, washing detergent to get by for a long time and really cheap. Hey, thanks for watching. Thanks for coming along with us. We hope we earned your subscription. If we haven't, please subscribe. Hit the like button. It helps us in the YouTube algorithm. Subscribing helps us as well. And so we really appreciate it. And have a great and wonderful day. God bless you.
God bless you. I'm going to go to the mailbox. It went off, didn't it?
It went off.
Okay.
See you guys later.